Hey, I'm Parker Lesher. I'm here with Ms. Brzezowski talking about the new fries coming to Calhoun very soon. Can you tell us about the fries?
Sure. The fries are a new crinkle cut fry, as you can see, and it has seasoning on it. So it's not just your regular fry that we have that has a little crispy on it, gives it a little flavor so it's not plain, because salt is not allowed in the cafeteria. So these with seasoning should give us a little extra flavor.
That sounds amazing. And the free samples that you had the other week, whenever they were handing them out, and I actually got to taste them. I think Bailey had, I got to taste them as well, but they remind me of the Zaxby's fries. And with that seasoning, they taste just like Zaxby's. And I'm sure a lot of people, and I know a lot of people, love Zaxby's fries. So I think they'll be a very good hit here in Calhoun. When will they be coming to the cafeteria?
We are going to serve the new fries on Thursday, Tuesday, and Thursdays, and our old fries on Monday and Wednesday. So look for them on Tuesday and Thursday.
Sounds good. Thank you. And thank you for letting us come and interview about the fries.
You got to test the fries.
All right.
Let me get you a tray.
So you want to go first? You want to do the honors of tasting the fries?
All right. I'll try.
We gotta get the ASMR crunch.
Probably one of the best fries I've ever tried.
There we go. Okay. I'm gonna see if the hype lives up to it.
Did you eat those every Tuesday and Thursday?
Yeah.
And like I said, it's fresh. Like Zaxby's.
They're cooked fresh as the kids are coming through. So it's a fresh French fry for everybody. It doesn't sit and wait and get soggy.
Yeah, that's what, like I said, they taste like Zaxby's fries. So
yeah, it's basically
a little bit of ketchup. You know, now we gotta make our homemade Zaxby's sauce. Then.
The boom boom sauce?
Have
you tried the boom boom sauce?
The boom boom sauce, yeah. I remember I used to get that with the chicken. That tastes just like, that's the new wave.
If you could go anywhere in the world for spring break, where would you go?
Probably Hawaii, because I want to surf in Hawaii.
I guess Australia. Mm-hmm. Pretty good. Looks like it's got good food. And I just eat the whole time.
Yeah. Home. Just go home.
If I could go anywhere in the world for spring break, I would have to say I would love to go to Australia. Minus the spiders, of course. I've always wanted to go there just to be able to see all of the beauty, to see the harbor in Sydney, to see all the animals, and to really take in the culture of Australia. So if I could go anywhere, Australia it would be.
Italy. It's just really pretty over there. It's really beautiful. Okay.
If you could go anywhere in the world for spring break, where would you go?
Canada. I would go to Egypt and see the pyramids.
If you could go anywhere in the world for spring break, where would you go?
Probably the beach. Just because it's sunnier down there and there's water and we don't got much around here.
The Bahamas, because we have a house down there and on the beach, and we usually go down there every year, so Bahamas.
Oh man, that's a tough one. I would probably go to San Marino. Why would I go to San Marino? Because there's beautiful beaches, there's a castle, and it's far away from here. So I'd like to have a little break to San Marino. You guys don't know about San Marino? Look it up. It's a beautiful place. Yeah.
So they're testing different water samples for water quality to discover what's in an unknown sample that I collected from my yard yesterday. So they have four different samples that they're testing it against. One is just tap water, so that's straight from the Calhoun tap here at school. This one has dish detergent in it, like what you'd put in your dishwasher, along with some bleach. This is fertilizer, basically it's orchid fertilizer. And then this one has organic material in it. So they're testing each of these four samples to figure out how much dissolved oxygen oxygen they have, nitrates, phosphate levels, as well as dissolved oxygen. And then they're comparing what they find here to the unknown sample to figure out where is the contamination from. Is it contaminated with organic material? Is it contaminated with fertilizer? Is it contaminated with detergent? Or is it just tap water?
Basically, right, we're measuring like the pH levels, right? And like the dissolved oxygen levels and like in water, right? It's like a 6.5. Well, that's what she told me. And yeah, that's basically all we're doing, bro. We're just testing the pH levels in waters.
We're seeing which ones, which we have color coding and some other stuff to it where we can see what levels they are. And basically it's telling how, like the world and everything, how we put toxins, pathogens, and other things into our water that we did not know about. And it's a pretty good, pretty cool thing to learn about in this time. And that's pretty much it to it.
Hello, I'm Parker Lesher, and I'm back with What's New in Calhoun. Starting April 1st, there will be a carnival at the Calhoun Outlets. As you can see behind me, a short video that Coach Long took. The ticket prices will be one for $25 and four for $75, so you actually save $25. As I mentioned, it starts April 1st and ends April 11th, so if you don't have anything to do during spring break, there will be a carnival at the Calhoun Outlets. Go check it out. Hey, Bob.
Hey.
What do you call a bear with no teeth? A gummy bear! Ha 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 ha.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Chicago Theater is proud to announce a first. The first time anywhere there's been an act of this nature. Not only one little lady, but two. You've read about them in the papers, and now here they are, Chicago's own Killer Dillers, those scintillating sinners, Roxy Hart and Val McKelly. 5, 6, 7, 8.
We are here with our lovely teacher from the Culinary Arts program. So, Ms. Atkins, do you care to explain what are you doing here today?
Today my students are making skillet flatbread and hummus. So they are going to make a bread that is not risen by yeast. So they're making a dough, letting it rest, and then they are going to be frying it in a skillet. And hummus is a dip made out of chickpeas and spices.
Interesting. So we are here with our famous Mylon Gardner, and we see here that he has chopped some green peppers. So Mylon, what exactly are we doing here?
Sauteing the peppers to put them in our hummus.
So we are here with Braylon. So Braylon, what exactly are you doing here in this pot?
Doing some chicken peas boiling. I'm boiling them. I think that's what we're doing.
So Ms. Atkins, I love the lovely presentation. So what do we have here?
Today we have some hummus with garlic and lemon juice, and the seasoning on top is called za'atar, which has sumac in it, which is the primary ingredient. And then these are some fried flatbreads, and it's just a simple dough made out of flour and baking powder and water, which we then flattened into circles and fried in some vegetable oil.
It looks amazing, Ms. Atkins. No words can explain my satisfaction.
Wrong answer only. Who is the first prime minister?
Burrito.
Mr. Guar, wrong answers only. Who's on the $10 bill?
P. Diddy.
Patty, wrong answers only. What's Barack Obama's last name?
Obama?
That was I said. Wrong answers only. What's Barack... Oh, crap. Patty, wrong answers only. What's 2 times 2?
Giraffe.
Good question. Nathan. Oh, my God. Wrong answers only. What's a food that starts with the letter A?
Apples.
Chloe, wrong answers only. What's your secret obsession?
Wrong.
Your mom.
Chloe, wrong answers only. Who's the first prime minister?
Obama.
Anna, wrong answers only. What's your favorite color?
Are you stupid?
What's your favorite color?
Dr. Marcus, wrong answers only. How tall is the Apple Tower?
12 feet.
Thank you. Casey, wrong answers only. What's the smallest thing in the world?
The Eiffel Tower.
What? Wrong answers only. Cats or dogs? Okay. Wrong answers only. What's your favorite subject?
Me?
Yeah. Wrong answers only. What's your favorite subject? Wrong answers only. What's your secret obsession?
Bottle records.
Wrong answers only. What's your favorite food?
Vegetables.
Wrong answers only. What's your secret obsession?
I like playing basketball with my cat.
Wrong answers only. Showers or baths?
Ocean.
Really? Wrong answers only. Where were you born?
Narnia.
Wrong answers only. What's the plot of Nemo?
Aliens.
Wrong answers only. What's the best flavor?
Milk.
Kennedy. Wrong answers only. When life gives you lemons.
Say what?
Wrong answers only. When life gives you lemons.
Make cat.
And I'm with
Hector Rodriguez, and we're gonna be teaching you Spanish words you need to know. So basically, we're gonna tell you guys famous Spanish words from Spanish songs or just Spanish words in general, so you guys know what they mean.
First, we have despacito, which is in English is slowly.
But like, how would you use that in a Spanish sentence? How could you use slowly, despacito? How could you use that, like, in a Spanish sentence? Like, what would you say?
Ella manejó tienda.
Supermercado.
Supermercado. Muy despacito.
Muy despacio.
What about mi corazón? How would you use that? Muy grande.
Yeah, mi corazón es muy grande.
That means my he has a big heart. Yeah.
All right. Gasolina. What's that in Spanish?
Gasolina. I'm gonna put gas.
In your car?
Yep. Okay. Yo voy a poner gasolina en mi carro.
Nice. Alright. What we have here is Feliz Navidad.
Which is Merry Christmas.
Do you know that song though?
Hmm?
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
Go.
Feliz Navidad. I don't know the. I don't know the other lyrics. Nunca te olvidaré. Now what does that mean, Miguel? Do you know?
No.
You don't?
I'll never forget you. Yeah. So how would you use that?
Si te vas, nunca te olvidaré.
And what's that mean?
If you go, I've never forget you.
That's nice, that's nice. No quiere enamorarse de mí. How would you say that in a sentence? Can you tell us, please, Miguel?
Ella no quiere enamorarse.
What does corre mean?
Runs.
Oh,
I'm
okay.
Going to the park. Run.
Oh, nice.
Voy al parque corriendo.
You're running to the park?
Yep.
Amor. I can handle this, Miguel. So basically, amor means love. And if you want to use that in a sentence, I can be like, Miguel, te amo. Basically saying, I love Miguel.
Yep.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do you love me back?
Well.
What does dinero mean?
Money.
Oh, wow. Okay. How would you use that in a sentence?
I have money. Yo tengo dinero.
Well, okay. This might be the hardest word ever. Okay. You can't be looking, Miguel. How do you say library?
Library.
No.
Yeah,
library. Nah. You're wrong. I'll give you a hint. It starts with a B.
Oh, la biblioteca.
Yeah, bro.
It was the same.
We got one more for you, Miguel.
Just
what does escuela mean?
School.
All right, there you have it. Escuela means school. Now, can you tell them how you would use it in a sentence?
I'm going to school. Yo voy a ir a la escuela.
Iglesia. How do you say church in Spanish?
Iglesia.
Exactly.
Yeah,
that's another word they get to know. All because of you, Miguel. All right. That's all the words we have.
Okay. So, thank you for being with us, and hope you enjoy our
Miguel, meeting. You're so humble. I like it. Goodbye.
Hello. 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 My God. Yeah.
Why?
Because we need this video to be funny. Okay. Hi, I'm Olivia Greason, and I'm here today with...
her favorite brother, Cole Greason.
Anyways,
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you should be. Would you like to introduce what sport you play and your positions and grade?
I play baseball for Calhoun High School.
Showing the logo does not help. That's the school's logo.
I said that I played baseball for Calhoun High School while I was doing that.
Yes, y'all.
And then I'm a senior and I'm a pitcher. I only pitch because I can't pitch.
Why?
I can't. For me, it's just really difficult to put a bat on a ball. It's just so.
I can tell. What's your favorite memory of the sport?
Well, since I'm a pitcher, one of my few hits was when I was 12 years old on a crappy travel ball team, and I hit, they pitch walked or intentionally walked the guy in front of me, and they put him on base, so his base is loaded, and I pieced one up to right center. It felt pretty good. And I
remember. It was, you were wearing a red jersey then, right?
Yeah.
I remember that. It was his only hit of the season.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to just go ahead and give a quick shout out to the coaches?
Shout out my boy Bennett. He's lucky he plays baseball coach because he's balding. Shout out Coach Wiggins. I guess. He likes Mountain Dew.
1 eternity later.
Did you even mention Coach Henderson there?
Yeah, give me a minute. I gotta mention all of them. We got Coach Henderson through my boy Chip. He got thrown out when he... Chip Henderson, yes sir. He got ejected. Yeah.
For what?
Because he argued with an umpire. An umpire. He was very sensitive.
I mean, men can be sensitive too. Is there any other memories you have? Like, what? It doesn't have to be a good memory.
when we lost to Cartersville at home and Bus at Trinity twice at their place, three games in a row, that left a bad mark. I got PTSD from that.
Yeah, I'm sure it hurt your ego a little bit.
Oh, definitely. No, it definitely humbled some of the guys that needed humbling.
They needed what?
They needed humbling.
Oh,
so
true.
Yeah, no, I agree. Really, we did.
Do you want to drop names?
No, of course not. This isn't. What are you doing? This isn't TMZ. This isn't drama.
It's an expose. I think the interview went as good as it could, considering the circumstances. There's only so much you can ask about baseball in the first place, because it's a sport. There's a ball, and you throw it, and people try to hit it.
Gabe,
we are back.
We're doing the spicy wing challenge.
All right, first off, I want to say this. We got some stuff here. We got some pixie sticks, water, our drink of choice, and some milk.
First one to drink milk loses.
Or anything.
We're going, no, we can drink our water and our
whatever. No.
Okay.
No.
We got the
problem. They didn't label the wings, so we're going off smell alone.
We have them ordered from least hottest to most hottest, and we think we're correct. So, we're gonna start. You wanna grab a wing?
Sure.
All right, this is the first one. Bottoms up.
He's kinda scared.
Pretty good.
That's good, it's just a wing.
Not that hot.
Not hot at all.
Not at all.
It's not hot at all.
Not hot. Pretty good.
I ate almost all
day. It was really good. Mm-hmm. Pretty good.
No.
I rate that like on a hotness scale, like a 4.
That's about right. I rate that like a 2.
Really?
It wasn't hot at all.
It was just like a little. Just a
no,
little.
I didn't get any spiciness from that.
Alright. Well, let's let's move up to the next wing.
Wing 2. Oh, did we mention that one of them, like the last one, was like 500,000 Scoville?
Yeah, like it's a lot. It's like comparable to hot ones. So
here we go.
This one's pretty good too. It's not that hot.
Mm-hmm. I agree. I actually like it better than that one.
Yeah. It's only like slightly spicy. If you want to try this yourself.
I was dreading this, but this is actually
this is yeah. Just us eating wings. Us eating wings. If you want to try this yourself, just go to Zaxby's. Order Insane Tongue Torch
what,
Nuclear
what didn't make What doesn't make sense is they had wings that were less spicy than that.
Mm-hmm.
They had like 4 of them.
They're less spicy than this.
Yeah, I don't understand that. No, all right. I think this is where it's going to start getting like hot.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty bad. Alright, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, I can feel it.
Yeah, this is. I can feel it.
I feel it already.
Mmm. Oh no. Oh no.
It's just getting worse.
Every bite's getting hotter. Oh god.
I finished my wing. We probably. Did they bring nap? Yeah, they did. Mm.
Mmm. Oh god. Mmm.
I'm okay. It wasn't that bad.
Yeah, that's spicy.
It is spicy. These two, this one especially, not that bad. This one, there's a little bit of spice. This one's spicy.
Yeah, that's spicy. For this next one.
That means this is the death wing.
Yeah. Alright. 3, 2, 1. Mmm. Oh.
I don't feel it yet.
Oh, I feel it. Oh, that's hot.
Oh, I feel it.
Oh my god. Clean the wing. Clean the wing. Mmm. Oh god.
Oh.
Oh no.
Oh, it's just getting worse.
Oh.
Oh God.
Oh.
I can't. Come on. There's a cab. Get it out.
Oh no. So guys, I'm not doing okay, but I'm not drinking yet. You want to do another wing?
I already lost.
Oh, I'm going to do another wing.
Oh no.
Oh, it's so bad. It is really bad.
Oh my God. Oh. Oh.
I can't.
My throat. Oh. The sugar makes it worse.
Oh.
Oh. Oh my God. Oh. What are you doing? What is he doing? Okay.
Give me that.
Rating. 2 out of 10 spicy.
2 out of 10.
4
that's
out
about,
of 10.
That's about 3 or 4.
This
that's
is,
a 5.
It's 5. This is an 8.
10. No, that's a 10.
Oh.
That's hot.
Oh. Try the hottest one right here, sir.
Is it like...
Take your pick.
No, it's pretty good.
It's just, pretty just good. Just try it.
Yeah. We got milk, we got sugar, we got,
Can I try one of those first?
No.
No, those are good. That's why we're not giving them to you.
Dude, it looks like blood's on it.
it's fine. Just eat it.
It's okay.
Just take a big bite.
Dude, you sound like you're dying.
Just take a big bite. Mm. Clean it.
Don't wipe your eyes. That's a bad idea.
Clean it.
He's shaking.
Oh.
Ethan, is that, what would you rate that?
Oh my God.
Yeah, rate it. Rate it for me.
On a spicy scale, 1 to 10.
A 15.
It's hot. It's very hot.
Recording.
We're going to Chick-fil-A with the out trip. My car's
again.
It didn't go boom, zoo, zoo. There's two people talking on a bridge.
Oh, maybe I can get them in the camera. Pause on
him.
You better pause on him.
Okay. There's a police.
I'm having a panic attack.
Bruh.
We almost killed a person.
She just walked on out there and gambled her own life.
Some lady is staring at me.
Hi, lady.
Don't stare back. That's illegal.
That made no sense.
Nope.
What is our order? Go over it.
No.
Okay.
So now we're gonna walk down a really, really long sidewalk while also seeing some trees and plants along the way. That's pretty much what we'll be doing for the rest of this video.
My hair looks bad.
No coughing.
COVID.
It's the wind. This lipstick is part of the wild.
Rawr.
There's another trail that intersects with this one. Which way should we go?
Intersection!
That's a geometry term. Which way should we take?
Left or right, comment down below.
Because she wanted to turn around. Because she didn't want to walk anymore.
No, we don't got no more time.
Imagine not wanting to walk anymore. What you doing?
Camping.
We have been walking for a total of like 5 minutes now and I'm freezing. Everywhere I'm looking now, I'm
surrounded by your embrace. How scenic.
Literally walking into nothingness.
This looks like a Microsoft screensaver.
Look at how pretty.
Now that's what I call a fresh water source.
Boy, if you don't...
Wildlife.
That is the direction we're supposed to be going.
This trail is taking us this way.
It's the way that we're supposed to go.
If you never see us again, you know why.
The rules don't apply.
The rules do apply.
Not to me.
Okay.
Bird box stuff right there.
We're having a little tea party.
With no tea.
We've got tea.
Who's bothering you?
Me and you.
Oh, okay. She left me sitting here stranded.
Let's go off-roading.
When I'm on the road.
Back on the road.
Where are we gonna go?
I want fries.
Right.
So we're back in the car.
This wasn't great.
It's like humid and windy and gross, and I was in jeans and I wasn't dressed right. Subwide.
Subwide.
Bye.